Hello students, in today's video we will be seeing about Dhondia Vagh 1800. Now Dhondia Vagh was a soldier in Hyder Ali's military. Now let us see more details about Dhondia Vagh. After the death of Tipu Sultan, many rebellions and protests against British took place in Karnataka. So now we have seen about the different Anglo-Mysore wars. We have seen about Hyder Ali, we have seen about Tipu Sultan, and we have seen what all happened in the Anglo-Mysore wars. After the death of Tipu Sultan, many rebellions and many protests started against the British rule in Karnataka. These were armed rebellions and took place during the first part of 19th century. All these were violent and armed rebellions, and these took place in the first part of 19th century. Among these rebellions, the rebellion led by Dhondia Vagh was very important. There were many other people who were leading rebellion or who were against the British rule, but among all the rebellion, the one led by Dhondia Vagh was very important. Now Dhondia Vagh was born in a Maratha family of Chennagiri in Karnataka only. He was born in a Maratha family. He was very brave, and hence he was called as the Vagh, or meaning the tiger. So Dhondia was born in a Maratha family of Chennagiri. He was very brave and hence was called as the Vagh, or which means the tiger. He was a cavalry soldier in Hyder Ali's army. So Dhondia Vagh started his career as a cavalry soldier in Hyder Ali's army. Later he grew to the position of military general. Because of his bravery and because of his good performance, he started as a cavalry soldier, but later he grew to the position of a military general. He fought along with Tipu and later built his own private army. So after the death of Hyder Ali, naturally he joined Tipu's army. He fought along with Tipu, but later Dhondia Vagh built his own private army. He had some difference of opinion with Tipu Sultan, and because of that he later formed a private army. So after the death of Tipu Sultan, many rebellions and protests against British took place in Karnataka. Among them, the rebellion led by Dhondia Vagh was very important. He was born in a Maratha family of Chennagiri, and because of his bravery he was called as the Vagh or tiger. He started his career as a cavalry soldier in Hyder Ali's army and later grew to the position of military general. He fought along with Tipu and built his own private army. Later he was imprisoned due to differences with Tipu. So I told you he started having some difference in opinion with Tipu Sultan, and it is said that in the third Anglo-Mysore war he deserted Tipu and he went off, but later he was imprisoned by Tipu. After the fourth Anglo-Mysore war, the British released him from the prison. So after the fourth Anglo-Mysore war, when the war prisoners were released, Dhondia Vagh also was released from the prison. He built a small army and started his operations. So from then he started his operations. He built his own small army and started his operations. The unhappy soldiers of Tipu's army was organized by him in his army. So what was his strategy? He started organizing the people who were unhappy with Tipu. So the unhappy soldiers of Tipu's army was organized by him in his army. He also got the support of feudatory rulers who had lost the power. The rulers who had lost their power, they were also taken to his army. And now he started his operations and he captured Bidanur and Shivamoga forts. His attempt to capture Chitradurga fort was unsuccessful. So after capturing Bidanur and Shivamoga fort, he attempted to capture Chitradurga fort. But that attempt was a failure. He was unsuccessful. So during this time, Lord Wellesley tried to check this rebellion. So during this time, British caught their attention on the activities of Dhondia Vagh, and Lord Wellesley tried to check this rebellion. An attack was organized on Shivamoga, Honali, Harihara and other places under the control of Dhondia. So which all places were under the control of Dondia, those places were attacked by the British. That is, Shivamoga, already we know Shivamoga Fort, Bidanur Fort and all were captured by Dondia. So all these places were attacked by the British. Dondia lost his base, and after the capture of Shikaripura, he ran away towards Guti. So Dondia, when all the places under his control was attacked and captured by the British, he ran away towards Guti. So Dondia was imprisoned due to difference of opinion with Tipu Sultan. After the 4th Anglo-Mysore War, the British released him from prison. After this, he built a small army and started his operations. He organized his army with the unhappy soldiers of Tipu, and he also got support of feudatory rulers who had lost their power. He captured Bidanur and Shivamoga Fort. He tried to capture Chitradurga Fort, but that was not successful. Lord Wellesley tried to check the rebellion of Dondia Wagh, and what they did, an attack was organized on Shivamoga, Honali, Harihara and all the places under the control of Dondia. So with this attack from the British, Dondia lost his base, and after the capture of Shikaripura, he ran towards Guti. Guti was under the control of Nizam of Hyderabad. So the place Guti was under the control of Nizam of Hyderabad. So Dondia had ran towards Guti, and that place was under the control of Hyderabad Nizam. When he was attacked by Nizam's army, he ran towards the regions of Maratha. So when Dondia ran towards Guti, he was attacked by the army of the Hyderabad Nizam. And when he was attacked there also, he again ran towards the regions of Maratha. The Maratha army attacked him and captured most of his horses, camels and arms. So wherever he went, he was attacked. So when he reached Guti, he was attacked by Hyderabad Nizam's army, and then he ran towards Maratha. There he was attacked and captured by the Maratha army, and they captured most of Dondia's horses, camels and arms. He continued his warfare in spite of all these. We already have seen he was known for his bravery. So even after being attacked from all sides, he continued his warfare. Many rulers like the French at Mahe of Malabar extended their support to him. So those rulers who were against British rule, example like the French, they extended their support to Dondia. So the French at Mahe of Malabar, that is, Mahe was formerly a part of Kerala, now it is a part of Puducherry. So the French who were rulers at Mahe of Malabar extended their support to Dondia Wagh. The British who took over the Shirahatti killed many followers of Dondia Wagh. So now British also were not remaining silent. They killed many followers of Dondia Wagh. So all these were the activities done by Dondia Wagh. So Dondia ran towards Guti, and Guti was under the control of Nizam of Hyderabad. When he was attacked by Nizam's army, he ran towards Maratha area, and the Maratha army also attacked him, and they captured most of his horses, camels and arms. But still he continued his warfare. He got support of some rulers like the French at Mahe, and the British who took over the Shirahatti killed many followers of Dondia Wagh. So now let us see about the end of Dondia Wagh. Lord Wellesley decided to end the adventures of Dondia Wagh. So now the British felt that the adventures of Dondia Wagh is going on for a long time. Now it is time to end the adventures of Dondia Wagh. So Lord Wellesley decided to end the adventures of Dondia Wagh. They also requested the help of local rulers. So they wanted the help of some local rulers, and they wanted to end Dondia Wagh's adventures. The British tried to defeat the army of Dondia, which used to move in areas between Tungabhadra and Malaprabha. So they wanted to defeat the army of Dondia, which used to move in areas between Tungabhadra and Malaprabha, and they attacked him from all directions. So they very strategically, the British attacked the army of Dondia Wagh from all directions. When he left Raichur, he was followed by the British. So British did not leave him even when he was going away. They followed him even when he left Raichur. When he was caught in between Maratha army and Hyderabad Nizam's army, the British attacked him near Yelaparavi and killed him at Konegal. So they attacked him from all directions, they followed him, and finally he was caught in between Maratha army and Hyderabad Nizam's army. That time the British attacked him and killed him at Konegal. That was the end of the rule or the at the rule of Dondia Vag. After the death of their leader, the followers of Dondia were scattered. So he has organized a small army, and after the death of their leader, naturally the army and his followers were scattered. The British captured a large amount of arms and ammunition from him. So Lord Wellesley decided to end the adventures of Dondia Vag. The British tried to defeat the army of Dondia, which used to move in areas between Tungabhadra and Malaprabha. And they attacked him from all directions. Even when he left Raichur, he was followed by the British. When he was caught in between the Maratha army and the Hyderabad Nizam's army, the British attacked him and killed him at Konegal. After the death of their leader, the followers of Dondia captured, and the British had captured a large amount of arms and ammunition from him. So it is said that Dondia Vag had the title Ubayalogeshwara, that is master of two worlds. So this was about the adventure of Dondia Vag, which happened in 1800. So I hope you have understood all the points explained in today's video. If you feel my videos are helping you in your studies, please do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. And if you want videos on any other topics, you can ask in the comment section. I'll be making videos on those topics. I hope to see you soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.